Y'all, I said this once, and I'm going to say it again. I'm going to say it one more again. The playoff, the bubble, has produced some of the best basketball I have watched in a very, very long time, man. Like, it's really been exhilarating to watch. And it was crazy, like, you know, we all love the effect of the crowd, and we love the home court advantage for our teams that we're favoring in the playoffs or whatever. But to have it on, like, an even playing field where it's no crowd for nobody at all, and you just got to go out there and hoop, it's brought basketball to a whole different level. I'm watching players ascend in a way that you like, damn, are they really about to take that next leap and become tonight like the future stars of tomorrow? Because I'm watching Jamal Murray and Donovan Mitchell go back and forth like this. And this is I'm really at the edge of my bed. Like, god damn, like what's going to happen next? I'm watching them trade big basket after big basket, three after three after three. And I'm sitting here like, I'm going to say this for real. LeBron, my dog, but he going to have to get his chips and go ahead and ball because these young boys are trying to come with it. From Jason Tatum to Donovan Mitchell to Luka Doncic to Jamal Murray, these young boys are hungry. They hungry. They want to make their name and they want to prove that they belong on that big stage. And that's what they're doing. I remember when Jamal Murray was at Kentucky, right? He was in a backcourt with Tyler Ulis. And I remember watching how dynamic that backcourt was. I was in grad school at Arkansas State University, and I was trying to watch every single game they played because we had the SEC Network down there in Arkansas. And I was trying to watch them every single time they played at Kentucky because they were just that fun to watch. Watching Jamal Murray come off them screens and knock down them threes, like he was catch and shoot. He was fire. And all I'm thinking in my head is, if this boy can put it together and play on the next level like this, he going to be something special, right? And I remember he was averaging like a dub. And I'm thinking, like, if he can do this in the NBA, it's going to be something fun to watch. Again, I mentioned, he was only averaging 18 points a game in the season. Now he's averaging like 35 or something like that. Something incredible. But to see the run he's making, fam is pulling up from three on a fast break and getting it all net, hitting all net, hitting people with the step back, hitting threes all in people's face. And I'm looking like, man, that young boy playing with a different type of energy up in him, right? And I'm seeing Donovan Mitchell come back with that same smoke. He want all the smoke. He really out here trying to will Utah. And if they lose, if they come back from 3-1 down, man, shame on Utah, fam. Because I'm like, because at first, I really thought Denver was going to win in the first place, right? But when Utah went on 3-1, I'm like, damn, like, what's going on? Like, because in a couple of them games, it was a blowout. And I'm like, what is going on with Denver, right? But how they responded since then, you got to commend that. You have to commend that. I'm talking about the play from Jokic, play from Jeremy Grant, you know, other additional role players, what, Monte Morris and them guys trying to help the load. But Jamal Murray has been something really, really special. He's been something like, I don't know, man. Like, I knew Jamal really had it, but watching this, I'm like, I don't know, man. That young boy, I don't think there's no fluke either. I don't think it's nothing is just a fluke. I don't think he's like, oh my God, he'll never get these type of highs in his career ever again. No, I think he can be this type of player for real. And I think that you will see that going forward. Now, the thing is, as much as I love watching Jamal Murray do his thing, I'm hearing Charles Barkley say this. And I'm like, why are they not doubling Jamal Murray? Why are they not trying to get the ball out of his hands or force him to take horrible shots? Try to get the ball out of his hand in some type of way. Guarding him one-on-one, he eating them boys up. Eating them boys up, and like, he lighting them up every single time, fanning them down. I'm like, bro, somebody kind of come trap him, double him. Like, come on, man. Get the ball out of his hands. Make Jeremy Grant beat you. Jokic is a monster, but make him do something with the ball. But then I remember, shoot, he was knocking down threes last night. You know, he still could stretch the floor. But I'm like, damn, like, they really out here? But you really got to make somebody else do something, man. Make Paul Millsap or somebody do something. Make Jeremy Grant and them work for it. But please, you got to get the ball out of Jamal Murray's hands. You have to, right? And defensively, I'm looking at Utah like, damn, all they got is Rudy Gobert defensively. And it's like, that's it. That's it. And, you know, Rudy been all right. He ain't been on nothing for real. He been all right. He ain't been on nothing. So it's just like, okay, Jamal Murray out there having his way for real. Everybody else, he cooking everybody. They're going to have to trap that boy. They're going to have to double him and force the ball up out of his hands. They're going to have to. Talk about Utah and the Utah Jazz. Donovan Mitchell, 44 points. He's been nothing short of excellent, right? Mike Conley had 21. But I want Mike got to come up big and help Donovan. During I know he just came back from having a child. I know that's a big thing. Blessings to him and congratulations to him. And to him and his wife. It's a dope thing. It's really a big children are a blessing. But I don't know, man. Mike had 21, but I feel like Mike can play better than what he did. I really do. Jordan Clarkson had 11 points. Rudy Gobert had 11 points. Like, come on. Donovan going to need some help. He going to need some help to try to get this series, get this W. Because it's really, it looked like it's going to slip away. Because Denver got all the momentum. It just reminded me of that momentum that LeBron and them had when they were playing Golden State. And LeBron and Kyrie was going off of 40 points together. They coming back, knocking each game down one by one. And it's starting to look like that type of momentum is in the Denver Nuggets' favor. So, and they both shot 50% from three. Donovan Mitchell was like 9 of 13 from three. Jamal Murray was 9 of 12. The boys out there, they was balling. They was hooping. Now, Utah missed, 9 free throws? Denver missed 3. So, the free throw misses can be something as well. Denver is out-rebounding them. Had 13 more rebounds. Denver had 5 more turnovers than them. I'm trying to think of points in the paint. Well, they nearly even in points in the paint. So, really, it's just like, all right, you're going to need some other players to step up and produce some more firepower for the Utah Jazz, for real. I'm looking at the notes or whatever. But, like, watching them has been something it's been super exciting. Like, I've been watching all these different games, and I ain't made no video about it. Because I really got thrown off by the death of Chadwick Boseman. That really, really, that hurt me. Like, I feel like I knew Chadwick Boseman. Then I found out Uncle Cliff Robinson passed away. And then you have John Thompson. John Thompson passed away, coach. The Georgetown Hoyas, Coach Dikembe Mutombo, Alonzo Mourning, Allen Iverson, Patrick Ewing, a host of all that different type, them Georgetown greats that came through at that time, man. So rest in peace to John Thompson as well. But yeah, man, this basketball here, like I remember, do y'all remember Jamal Murray at Kentucky? I was almost all my, I wasn't that close, but I remember because the person that I was most excited to watch in college playing ball was Kevin Durant. Kevin Durant was somebody I feel like I had to watch every single one of his games because I just knew he was just something different. He was something special. I remember watching D-Rose at the edge of my seat excited because that's a Chicago public school kid from around the way, from Simeon High School, right out here in the crib. So I was trying to watch every single game he played. I was watching it with excitement because I knew what he was capable of doing, right? But watching Jamal Murray, too, I remember, like, this dude about to fill it up. Him and Tyler Ulis are about to fill it up on whoever they about to play. It's going to be one hell of a game. They're going to be going back and forth and give it their all. Jamal Murray is out here giving it his all. Every bit of it. Every bit of it. And they need every bit of it, for real, for them to win these games. So the fact that he's been producing like that under these, it's a big pressure situation. Especially with the fact that, like, if they would have lost one more game, it would have been over with. They were down 3-1. So now they tied it up 3-3. We're going to a game 7. Let's see what the young boy is made of. Can he close it out? Or Donovan Mitchell and Mike Conley and them say, hell no. Will Rudy Gobert come alive and say, hell no. We getting this. We going to the next round. We going to see, man. It's going to be very interesting to watch, man. But I've just been grateful to... I've been really like excited to see these type of games and watch these young boys play, man. They've been playing at a whole different level. And I think that not having a crowd has really kind of worked in some of these teams' favor. You know what I mean? You don't really got the crowd roaring in your ear, people jawing at you, nothing like that. You really just got the other team. So it's helping people to carry that, like, okay, we're going to keep our composure and keep our momentum. Ain't nobody in the crowd throwing us off. Booing us when we at the free throw line, none of that. We ain't got to deal with none of them crazy interactions. It's just us and this team, and that's what's helping them. I guess probably stay focused and stay motivated to say we can do this. And they, damn, to tie this up 3-3 is crazy. But we going to see, man. I'm going to see if Jamal Murray can close out this game 7, him and Jokic. Or would Donovan Mitchell say, nah, it ain't happening, man. Y'all let me know what y'all think about this series. Machiavelli Mills TV. I'm out. Peace.